You're reading my mind with the tapes element of this conversation. You know, I am a big physical media nerd like you. Again, in my background, not only is there vinyl, but I'm big into video games, console video games, Nintendo, all that kind of stuff. I love physical media. One physical media I have never, ever gotten into, and this is no shade, is tapes. Now, I don't know if it was because of the year I was born and I was kind of in between mediums that were kind of prevalent at the time, but tapes never, ever did it for me. And I'm slightly embarrassed to say that, like, I really didn't catch this. I don't want to call it a fad or a trend because I feel like that's not giving it justice, but I've just been catching on to this wave of tapes in 2021. And I've been getting some, you know, some language that it's because of vinyl shortages and things like that, that bands have been leaning into this. EPs have been on the rise anyways, just because of the attention span and things like that.
Yeah.
So just to kind of hone in on it, do you think that this surge in tapes, is it because AI just haven't been paying attention, or is there some sort of connection with all of this that tapes really do seem to be surging right now?
I think it goes both ways. I think, like, there's definitely, the vinyl thing has definitely pushed it more, because with the delays and with minimum pressings, I mean, it is harder. A lot of people used to just do CDs, but CDs are just, I mean, they're pretty much dead at this point. And so tapes have been more personal. Like, it's, I mean, it's almost like a masochist type of relationship where it's like, well, who still has tape decks? Oh, now I got to go find a tape deck. Like, no, like, three people still manufacture them. So I got to go find one from, like, Goodwill or something. And, like, it's like a whole effort to actually do this. And then, even then, like, you can do, like, you can make it more fun. Like, you can personalize it, and you can, like, paint on them, and you can do whatever. And it's not going to stop the media from working on, like, a CD or on, like, vinyl or whatever. And so I think a lot of bands kind of tapped into that side of, well, I can just, you know, duplicate these on our own, and then I can make them unique for our people. And, like, I can make them more desirable and more fun to own. And, you know, even if they don't sound as good or whatever, like, people are just going to want it because it is just something interesting. It's an art piece. So I do think that, yeah, I think the shortages and the way things have been going lately have led to that. But I do think that in general, like, tapes have been kind of on their way back, probably in a nostalgic kind of manner, just like vinyl did.
Yeah.
And I think they were just leaning that way. And again, to go back to Joyful Noise, they were kind of quoted as, like, the first big label that brought tapes back, because they were bringing on bands like Deerhoof and whatnot, and being like, and Joan of Arc and, you know, Melvins or whoever, and just saying, hey, can we, like, press your back catalog to tape? And I mean, right there, like, that small box behind me is actually a Deerhoof box set of literally every album they've done on tape. And that's how they actually started to get their name out there, was to do all these, like, awesome tape releases for big bands and whatnot. And then it just kind of grew, and they now, you know, probably have like 600, 700 releases, and vast majority in vinyl. But I think there were kind of some labels that were already tapping into that side and realizing, like, there is a nostalgic aspect to this that people love, and people just, you know, it's more interesting than a CD, and it's more accessible than vinyl. And so it's a little bit of both.
It is a little scary, just from me loving video games and music. Like, I'm talking more in the video game realm. This is a conversation that's been coming up a lot lately, because PlayStation was talking about removing the PSP and Vita stores, digital stores.
Yeah.
And everybody's like, okay, wait a second. Then how do I get some of these games that literally don't exist physically?
Exactly.
And it really has been kind of like freaking me out thinking, and now there's even conversations about how gaming consoles and even like cartridges from Nintendo have a lifespan, like with chips in them and battery. Like, I mean, I hope I'm still kicking and wanting to play video games in 30 years. Like, that'll be awesome if that's the case. But it is kind of crazy to think that, like, there's a lifespan to some of this stuff.
Yeah.
And so I think that, like, vinyl, as you kind of said it, created this surge, and now almost how all things are cyclical, like this nostalgia stuff. The tapes are on the trend. I can't wait for CDs to come back. Don't get rid of them yet, Josh, because you know they're coming back at some point.